Hey there, guys and gals. Sony had a big announcement today. It was a Sony A6300. It's quite a punch, and I'm going to tell you all about it in this video. Stay tuned. Hey guys, why am I making this video? Sony didn't ask me to make this video. quite frankly, I'm making this video because people know I shoot Sony, and they have lots of questions anytime a Sony product is released. Today, while I was sitting in my living room working on some stuff, the Sony announcement came out and I started getting inundated with questions. So I decided the best way to answer them all would be to put out a video. I was very fortunate because I'm part of the Artisan program. Right after the launch event, all the artisans were able to hop on a phone call with Sony and kind of get some of the nitty-gritty of the presentation that they did in New York. And I'm gonna share what I can with you guys. First and foremost, I haven't used the A6300 yet, so just understand that very few people on planet Earth have. Some of the folks who were able to attend the launch event were able to mess around with it a little bit, but I'm gonna be able to have it in my hands in about a month, but I wanted to give you guys some ideas on the specs and what this puppy can do. I affectionately am calling this the Mini A7R2. I think this is seriously like so many of the amazing things from the A7R2, which you guys know I love, and is packed into a smaller body, and it's $2,000 less. So that's pretty awesome. It's pretty awesome if you ask me. So let me go through some of the specs. This really is a complete different camera than the A6000. I know a lot of people look at this as a successor to the A6000, but it really isn't. It's really a completely different camera. It's a brand new sensor, and that sensor enables you to do a lot of really awesome things. So it has 429 focal points. It covers the entire sensor. The autofocus on this thing is the fastest in the world. It can focus in less than 1/500th of a second. That's just ridiculous. I think where people are gonna love this camera is for event photography, sports photography, birding, wildlife. It has a beautiful 24 megapixel sensor. But the fact that it enables you to focus so quickly, because what it does is, it for the first time ever, it actually tracks the movement in a mirrorless camera for one of the Sony mirrorless cameras. So it's going to track that movement, and it's actually going to put a density of those pixels on whatever is moving inside of that sensor, inside of your viewfinder. So what that means is if you have people running, sporting events, something of that nature, a bird flying, it's going to track that much, much better than the A6000 or even the A7R II does. Sony says it's their best focusing system, and I can't wait to put that to the test. And when I get my hands on one, believe me, I'm going to share the results with you guys. Now, I called it the Mini A7R II, and here's why. Because it has better focus, and there's lots of reasons, 4K video, all the things that I love about the A7R II. But the thing that really impresses me about this camera is the fact that it has the same ability to put Canon lenses on it and Sony A-mount lenses on it. That is a huge win. Up to this point, we've been subject to having to use the LAEA4, which has a cluster of focal points right there in the middle. It doesn't give you a lot of latitude. If you work with it, you can get it to work, and I have. But when I've strapped on that A7R II and started using Canon lenses and Sony A-mount lenses, it just really changed how I was able to shoot, because now there was a full array of lenses for me to use in whatever focal length or aperture that I wanted. Now, with this camera, instead of having to buy the LAEA4 adapter, you can, just like the A7R II, you can put that LAEA3 adapter and go to town. That's huge. So, you know, for all those people who don't want to spend the money on the A7R II, this A6300, it's ridiculous. The fact that you're able to do that, you can put the Canon lenses on it, Sony A-mount lenses on it, and unlike the LAEA4, with the LAEA3 adapter, the ability to focus is greatly enhanced. So given the fact that you can use phase detection, contrast detection for your autofocus is a big deal, and given the fact that there's so many focal points, it really is going to set this camera apart, especially at the price tag of $1,000. I think that that's fantastic. You can use all your current Sony E-mount lenses on it, as well as the FE lenses. And you know, I know they came out with new lenses today. We'll talk about those in a separate video. Now guys, one of the things that is a big deal to talk about is the viewfinder. This camera is in a class of its own when it comes to how it handles live view, how it handles its ability to mitigate lag. Now in my other cameras, my other Sony mirrorless, I really haven't noticed too much of an issue. But this is the first time, this camera does 11 frames a second, but this is the first time that you can shoot up to 8 frames a second and there's, the lag is, what they say, it's like 0.005 of seconds. It's ridiculous what it can do. And I think that that allows you guys to be able to shoot sports and whatever else that there might be. Now again, I wanna see it, I wanna put it in my hands and I wanna test it, just like you guys do. But by the specs of what we're being told, it's even faster than a lot of DSLRs when it comes to that shutter. When that shutter blackout occurs, this is even faster than that, and that's an advantage of mirrorless photography. And again, I'm gonna test it, don't worry. Now, one of the things that excited me about the A7 R2 and the A7 S2 was the incorporation of 4K video. Now, Sony has told us that the 4K video on the A6300 is going to be better than those cameras. Now, I have a hard time believing that because I love the 4K video on those cameras, but Sony said it's the case. So why is the 4K better? Well, for one reason, that sensor is so advanced. It's taking that information in at 6K, it's reading it at 6K. And then it oversamples it down to 4K. Now there's no pixel binning. In other words, pixel binning pretty much is when it kind of looks at same information, and if nothing changes inside of the composition, it doesn't collect information for each and every bit of that composition, if that makes sense. The reason that it's good when cameras don't have pixel binning is because it reduces artifacts. So this camera does not have any pixel binning, which is fantastic. Pixel binning is just a way to kind of compress and save information, and this camera doesn't do it, which is fantastic. It has a direct pixel readout. It has S-Log3, so if you guys want to be able to have the most flexibility with being able to record video and your dynamic range, I think it's a 14 stops of dynamic range. That's awesome. So again, all of this packed into a $1,000 body. Now, just like other DSLR mirrorless cameras, this should be limited to the 29 minute 50 second mark of recording time. So that's kind of an interesting standard. I know the Panasonic GH4 doesn't do that. I have no idea how they got around it. Maybe they got their camera classified as a video camera. Maybe that's the way they did it, which is pretty cool. But this one does not do that, and no other camera that I know of except for the GH4 does. Let's talk about the body real quick. The body does look like an A6000, but different from the A6000 is this is a magnesium alloy body, so it's gonna be stronger for you. Now, I've dropped my A6000s many times. I've never broken one, but just in case people want something that's a little heftier and stronger, the A6300 is gonna be your best bet. The other great thing for video people is it is going to have a microphone jack and headphone jacks, and it didn't have that before, so in the A6000, so that's another benefit to this camera. So the one thing it doesn't have that I would have loved to have seen would be a 5-axis image stabilization. You know, that's something they've put in their bigger bodies, you know, all the A7, well, A7 R2, the A7 S2, the A7 II, but those are bigger bodies, and it's able to handle, because of the size, they can actually put the components in there for the 5-axis image stabilization. So it doesn't have that. I think that would be the only takeaway, so to speak, from the camera, but I think this thing's going to sell like gangbusters. I think for the price, I mean, Nikon just came out with their D500, and I'm sure it's a great camera in many respects, guys. I'm not Nikon bashing, but that Nikon's $2,200. Something is in that range. It's in the low 2000s. This is $1,000. Now, Nikon D500 has, dual card slots. This does not. So that's, it's never been a concern for me. For some people it is. It's never been a concern for me. And I know the Nikon D500, for example, the 4K video, they record in like 3-minute increments, which I don't understand. Maybe they'll come out with a firmware update that'll fix that. But guys, I think this is a great camera. I wanna put my hands on it. I wanna see how it goes. And I wanna see how the world responds to this. I think it's gonna be overwhelmingly positive. And combined with the new lenses that came out today, I think that Sony is just putting their foot on the gas pedal and going for it. So I hope this has helped, guys. Please let me know what questions you have. I definitely think that in the mirrorless market, there's nothing that compares to this in the APS-C size. I think that it's really the Mini A7 R2. And in some aspects, Sony says it's a little bit better, which, and I adore my A7 R2. I think you guys know that. So until next time, keep shooting. Never give up on your dreams. Find the right gear that works for you. I don't get paid when you or anyone else buys an A6300 or any Sony camera. I do these because people are interested in Sony. They want to know. And so I do these videos. I also do videos about urban exploration and weddings and all sorts of crazy stuff. And I'm not trying to sell products there either, guys, so keep that in mind. I'm doing videos that I think people want to see and trying to provide content that people are asking for. Like I always say, guys, remember, you only have one chance to get it right. Talk to you later. Bye. You guys still here? Hello? Talking to you. Hey guys, if you want to learn online with me, go to patreon.com/JasonLanierPhotography and you will be able to continue this craziness online from anywhere on planet Earth with me. If you want to join me live, go to JasonLanier.com/workshops and you'll get to see me in my full glory live and in person, guys. I think there's a smudge on there. Yeah, I got it. Talk to you later, guys. Bye.